Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. We're going to make a sweet bridge scene. Now in the last video, we have some of the track down and we are testing it out. But it's time to start working on the backdrop and the scenery. Now the backdrop is just simple hardboard. The paint, I'm not going to tell people which colors to buy because the lighting in your room would be different than mine. So I just got like a very light blue with a hint of gray to it. I used one of these little foam brushes. And the nice thing about this, it's a circular pattern. And I was just kind of testing it out, seeing how it would look this way, but the truth is I had to press a little bit harder. Same thing with the color greens, just to buy a variety and push a little hard, and this will give you your circular shapes. This way there's no brush strokes. This is how I do a lot of my painting. I don't use a brush that often. I use a lot of the foam brushes and triangular cosmetic wedges. These are cheap acrylic paints, between 50 cents and a dollar at Michael's, Walmart, etc. Just using photos that I have for reference, using different color greens. I did have to use a paintbrush to go into this area that I couldn't get with the foam brush. And so if you look, there are about three or four different colors of green. I did take the brush and kind of fix up some areas that I thought needed fixed up. What you don't see is I'll take a lighter color of green and make a distant hillside. And remember, the further away something is, the lighter the color. That's why if you look in the valley, it's lighter color. Now the backdrop has one purpose, and that's just to distract from the fact that there's a concrete wall behind you. It doesn't have to be fancy. Now this is the prototype of where I'm modeling. Now that we have this bridge, and there is a curve to it. Now, yes, it is straight here, but I'm going to take some creative liberties and try to make this just good enough. So we'll take a look. Don't beat yourself up over having to make everything exactly like the prototype. This is what I do. I'm using 0.030 thickness styrene. This is a 1-foot by 2-foot piece that I have from Evergreen. I'm using cars for reference, just like the prototype. It's a one lane in each direction, plus sidewalk. This is how I do stuff. People are like, well, what's the scale footage? You know what? I go by what looks right. And that's what I tell you guys to do, is just simply do what you think looks good to your eye. If you beat yourself up over trying to make it exact, you won't enjoy the hobby. So it's real easy with an X-Acto blade. With a 0.030 thickness, it does offer a curve. I just wanted to see, like, because remember, I'm doing auto racks and passenger cars, so I'm going to need some height to this thing. Not this much height, but to show you that it does curve. Now, force perspective, watch this. Just simple gray acrylic paint. We'll speed things up a little bit, because you don't want to watch me paint this in real time. So we want to make the road go off to the distance. So how do we do this? Your eyes will play tricks on you. Even though this is a flat backdrop, it's starting to look like the road's going off into the distance. I love this stuff, okay? So, just simple gray. You don't want to get too detailed because it is far away. Now, I'm not an artist. If I can do this, you guys can do this. Earlier in the year, I had videos sponsored by Skillshare, and that was pretty cool to learn all about painting from Skillshare. But yeah, so this will be the width of the road. How cool is that? Okay, so now we want to have this road go off towards the mobile homes. And in future videos, I'll be installing the mobile home, thanks to a friend of mine. Thanks, Roy. So now we want to bring the road back around and over onto a little bit more of the flat foreground. So how do we do that? It's starting to get a little wider. It's all force perspective. Paint some down here. Yeah, I was on caffeine that day. Look how fast I paint. All right, so just a little bit more to have the road go off to the distance, kind of fix it up a little bit. Now, a lot of this is going to be covered up by trees. I'm going to plant a lot of trees in future videos. So this is a relatively close-up shot, but I'm going to pan the camera back so you get a better overview of if you're in the train room and show you how it looks. Now I'm using Plastruct I-beams. Use what looks good to you. These are long, but I cut them down to be shorter than the road because I still have to make the bridge supports and everything. And you'll see what I mean in a little bit. So just simply use the X-Acto blade. You don't have to cut all the way through. All you have to do is scort and snap to even pieces. Here's the cool part. Watch this. I didn't think it would work, but it did. So I'm bending the I-beams against its natural shape. I didn't know if it would hold, but it does. Just gradually work at it and work at it. I didn't need to heat it or anything. Just a little by little. Superhuman strength. And look, I got two pieces and they're holding their shape. Now I turn the road over. I use my plastic weld and gradually glue the beams into place. Press it down firm. And when you got them, you got them. And look how cool it is. It keeps its shape. Yay, Deej. All right. So now I wanted to do the sidewalk and the sidewalk wall. Go by what looks good. This is what I did. I just got had some strips. I'm not using a sidewalk strip. Just simple plain strip. Just like the prototype. You'll see it in a future shot. And I glued a strip down for the sidewalk, and then I turned sideways another size strip for the wall, glued it, pressed it as close to the edge as possible, and look at that. Now the pedestrians have somewhere to walk, and there's a wall to protect them from falling in the river. It'll show up better whenever I paint it, I promise you that. All right, it's looking good. Now I needed to build some support. This is just simply making a couple pieces cut to the right size. And to figure that out, I just simply drew what I thought would look good. I took creative liberties for this. I made two pieces. And yeah, I thought that would be something kind of cool. It supports the bridge. Yes, it's angled, but you know what? I kind of like it. And when it's all blended in with the foam scenery, it's going to look really nice. Okay, so let's paint this. Now, I like to use Krylon for spray paint. You need primer. This is just simple gray primer. I primed both sides of the bridge. If you don't use primer, the paint doesn't stick. That's why you do this, and I did it outdoors, away from the camera. Okay, now, this is what I like to do for painting. I use those triangular cosmetic wedges. Get them at, like, Target, a bag of them for just a few bucks. They're better than paintbrushes. And, of course, I'm speeding this up. But what I like about this is, you know, I don't know how to airbrush, so I do this. Nice easy taps, and it gives you a smooth finish. I do have to use a paintbrush for the sidewalks. And just take your time with that. Use whatever color looks good to you. I went off of the video to see what kind of color I wanted to use. And so, yeah, I'm not going to show you the whole thing, but you get the gist. I found a good color match for the I-beams, and looking at the video, they did do a patch job, and so I used a different color for a couple of the patch jobs. And then I'm also going to weather it in just a minute. Just with a light dusting of brown paint for rust. I used a little bit of black here and there also for the lines. Just go off of photos and video. Google Maps, that's what I use. Got some oil drippings. And how does that look? All right, now of course I still have to do some support beams. I'll do that in future video probably. But it looks pretty good. And I still have to do some more details, but yeah, that's the prototype. And you see the curve right there. And this is Connellsville. You're seeing CSX Power headed back to its train. This is my inspiration for this section of the layout. Now, speaking of inspiring, I don't watch a lot of railroad videos on YouTube. I watch a lot of videographers. And the one guy that inspires me, he goes by the name of Rohan Chris. I think this guy is fantastic. He makes me laugh. His cinematography, his editing, storytelling is phenomenal. So I'll show you my favorite YouTuber, and he needs some subscribers. So subscribe to Rohan Chris. Yeah, I want to make my videos great, so that's why I follow great YouTubers like him. So big shout out to him. And I want to thank you for subscribing to my channel. If you haven't done so, please do so. For some reason, I see that YouTube is kind of removing some subscriptions, so you may have to resubscribe. Click that bell icon to be notified of future videos. Check out my website, DJSTRAINS.com, and follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and all that fun stuff, or on Patreon. I've been doing some private videos that show some stuff that I really can't show on here. So, yeah, a lot of cool stuff. More videos coming. So, thanks a lot. Long videos, right? All right. I'm going to go torture the cat.